I was just smelling it, it didn't smell like fish. Oh my god, they look extremely long. So this next piece, now the first thing I need to tell you about it is it molts. Oh my god, it's actually stuck to my lip gloss. Well, hello everybody. I hope you're all doing well. Welcome back to the channel and welcome to a new video. I had no intentions of filming today, guys. I was actually meant to be going out. I got myself ready, I'd done my hair and done my makeup, and then my plans got cancelled. But every cloud has a silver lining, because today I had a Mango, a H&M and a Zara order turn up. So I thought, as I'm all ready, do you know what? I'm going to sit down and I'm going to film a try on haul for you all. Before I get into this video, I do want to do just a little bit of a disclaimer, because my last two videos, well, one was a Zara and H&M haul and the other one was a capsule wardrobe haul. If we're talking about my capsule wardrobe, everything in that video I own and 100% recommend, and I feel like they're all super classic pieces. When you see me film haul videos, I do never keep all of this stuff. I just want to be honest with you all. No one needs this many clothes. The reason I want to say that though is sometimes you can watch these hauls online and you just feel like this is an excessive amount of clothes. And as I've kind of done two hauls back to back, I just feel like I wanted to say that to you guys so you just don't think, God, this girl is ordering a lot of stuff she doesn't need. Which is true. But all that being said, it is now a new season. We are obviously in autumn. You know how much I love autumn and I kind of wanted to revamp my wardrobe. But like I say, this is actually me trying these things on with you all, just giving you my review, and some of the things will be sent back. So here's a big box of stuff that I prepared earlier. By the way, if I sound a little bit funny in this video, I have been a little bit under the weather and I kind of lost my voice slightly this week. So if I sound a little bit funny, that is why. Okay, let's start with this big thing that's on top. I've already tried this on. I mean, you'll see in a minute what I'm gonna say, but let's just go through everything first. So I got this in a size. Let's just note the size, guys. Extra small to small. I always get so many comments in my videos about the fact that I wear everything oversized. It's a known fact, and I've said it so many times before. I like things to be oversized because I just find them a lot more comfortable. I feel like things look a lot more chicer when they're not so tight. And it's just the way I like to wear my clothes. But let's just take note of the sizing of this coat. Like I said, extra small to small. I had no intentions of this being big on me. Now, it's this gorgeous kind of oat colour. It's got a belt around it that kind of cinches you in. It's almost like a dressing gown style coat. It was kind of pricey. I actually have the price list here. This is definitely something I prepared earlier. So the coat was $169.99. So yeah, bloody expensive. So £170 basically. I'm sure now at this point you're seeing me in a cutaway. This thing is massive. I mean, I'm a UK size 10. I'm 5'3", so we all know I'm not that tall. But I'm not that small. Like, I am actually not that small. There's people a lot smaller than me. So how they're selling this coat as a size extra small to small, I have no idea. Because this honestly fits like a good medium to large. If it fit me properly, this coat would honestly be gorgeous. I would like to say, if you're a little bit taller, my sister should probably try this on actually, because my sister's about 5'7", I think my sister, maybe 5'8". And actually this probably would look quite good on her. But for me, it absolutely drowns me. I'm quite gutted about it as well, because I really did love it. But at the same time, for the price, I'm not actually that gutted, because it'd be quite nice to send it back and get the money back on my card. The quality of it's really lovely though, and if you are a little bit taller, then I probably would recommend it. But for me personally, I just can't get over how bad the sizing is. Next thing I picked up from Mango was this jumper. Now these jumpers, I actually picked it up in grey as well, which I'll show you in a minute. But these jumpers are actually the reason that I placed my Mango order. I went on just to have a little look because my friend told me there was a nice pair of boots on there. I didn't actually end up buying the boots, but obviously I bought these other bits. And this jumper caught my eye and I thought, oh, this actually looks really nice. And do you know what it is? It's really lovely quality. The material's really lightweight. It's a knit material, but it's quite breathable. Now, I picked it up in a size medium. It fits like an oversized fit, but not too oversized. Like, it just fits like a normal medium. This was, sorry, let me just get my price list back for you all. It was $35.99, which I think is actually really reasonable because it feels like really lovely quality. It's got kind of a little collar on it and then buttons here that you can obviously do up if you want it high neck. I prefer to wear it a little bit open neck, so you can like wear a necklace with it or something. Oh my god, my necklace is actually caught on it. Okay, I've broken free. But overall, yeah, I just really love this. I think it would look so nice with a pair of jeans or just a pair of leather trousers. Like almost a really easy, comfy basic just to chuck on. I liked it so much so this is the beige version. I then also got it in the grey. The grey material, funny enough, is actually a little bit different to the brown. So the brown's a lot softer. I've actually just realised how similar it looks to this top that I've got on. It's not that similar though, because this has kind of got this kind of knitted look where this is a ribbed look. By the way, this top was H&M last year, if anyone's looking at it and wondering where it's from. There's one from And Other Stories that is very similar, which I'll link down below, that I've seen them doing this year. By the way, does anyone shop on And Other Stories? I've never, do I have anything? I don't have anything from that shop, but I see a lot of nice things. So let me know if you want me to do an And Other Stories haul. I hate the name of that shop. Like, why is it called And Other Stories? Why don't they call it Other Stories? The And Other Stories sounds like you're saying it wrong. Anyway, let me know if you'd want me to do a haul from there. But what I was saying was, yeah, this material here is so much softer than the grey version. And I don't really get why, because, well, you'd think they'd be the same. I don't know whether they've dyed this and it's gone a little bit stiff. I'm unsure. But I picked this up as well just because I liked this one a lot. And once again, really nice with jeans, black leather trousers, black jeans, a skirt. Like, it would look nice with so many different things. And really good for that sort of transition kind of time where it's too cold to wear a t-shirt. Although at the minute, it's not cold at all. It's actually hot. But usually, too cold to wear a t-shirt, but too hot to wear like a really big, thick knit jumper. I feel like these would be really handy. And then the next thing I picked up from Mango was this. So, this is a cropped leather jacket. You might all know that I not long ago got a leather jacket from H&M, which I adore. Once again, that was something that everyone kind of hated on YouTube. They said it was far too oversized. I do agree, it was really oversized, but I still think it was cool, so I still kept it. This, though, is not so oversized. I picked this up in a size medium, and it was $139.99, which I think is actually quite reasonable for a leather jacket. Although I think my H&M one, which is a lot bigger than this, as you all know, I think that was about $129. So actually, it's not amazing value for money. But the leather is super soft. It's really kind of like a buttery leather, if that makes sense. It's got silver detailing, and then it's a cropped fit. So as much as I felt like I didn't really need a new leather jacket because I just got one, I kind of feel like I'm missing this kind of style from my wardrobe, like a cropped version. I feel like these are really nice to wear on a night out. Obviously, the oversized one isn't really like the most flattering thing ever. Like, for me, I think it looks really cool, but it's not that flattering. Where this would be really flattering, like, once again, with a pair of black trousers, a pair of heeled boots, a black roll neck, I just think this would look really classy. And something you could just definitely wear, well, you could wear it on a date. I always feel like a leather jacket for a date is really nice. Or like a night out, you could even wear it in the daytime. Like, it's so versatile, but it's just something I really felt like I was missing. I think I'm definitely going to be keeping this because I think it's hard to find a good leather jacket. Okay, now we're on to H&M. And for me, this season, I've said it in my last video, but I'm just going to say it again because I feel like they deserve the recognition. H&M is killing it. Like, honestly, every single time I go online, there's just more stuff that I want. This stuff, though, I actually all picked up in store because I took back, do you remember from my H&M haul, I took back the oversized brown coat, which I'm still so gutted about. I even said to the girl in the shop, because it sold out online, but I said to her in the shop, like, have you had it in at all? And she said, no, it's something that's like online only. So that's a little bit disappointing. But whilst I was there, of course, I ended up buying more stuff. I couldn't just take the coat back and get my money back. I went and spent more. So I picked up this first, which I absolutely love. So this is another one of those shacket jacket things. So it's between a shirt and a jacket. These are really good as well for this time of year because they kind of give you a little bit more warmth than a shirt would, but not as much warmth as a coat would because we don't need coats right now because it's not actually that cold. Do you know what I'm trying to say, guys? You can also layer up as well. You can put a hoodie underneath it, which is one of my favorite ways to wear this. I know it's a very basic way to wear it, but I like to dress basic because then it's just timeless and effortless and yeah, that's just my style, you know. I know you shouldn't really call yourself basic, like that is not a very nice thing to say about yourself, but like, I like to wear wearable outfits, you know, because don't get me wrong, sometimes I'll be out and I see someone and they've got like a really cool outfit on and stuff, but I just feel like you don't look very comfortable. I like to be comfortable and I like to buy things I know I can wear over and over again, year after year after year, hopefully. It was only $34.99. I picked it up in a size large so I could like layer underneath it. And I just love how it looks. It would look nice with so many different things. You could wear it with jeans, leather trousers. You could wear it with kind of like the suede leggings that I picked up from Zara not long ago. You could wear it with trainers, with boots. Honestly, the possibilities are endless. And you could definitely wear this in spring as well, you know. So it's kind of got like multi-purpose all year round, which is often what I look for when shopping online. I like to pick up pieces that I know I can wear multiple times. A lot of people say, oh, you never wear any colour, like, and stuff like that. But the reason I don't is just because if you don't wear colour, you can mix and match all your items. Sometimes, of course, I throw in a little pop of pink here and there, a little bit of purple. It's been known to happen. But I just like to stick to more neutral colours just so I can get more wear out of everything that I own. So this next piece, now the first thing I need to tell you about it is it melts. Oh my god, it's actually stuck to my lip gloss. It melts like a dog. Like, it really, really does melt. But it's gorgeous. It's also very itchy. Like, when I'm talking about itchy, I'm saying very itchy. I plan on wearing this, though, with a shirt. So when I've got a shirt underneath, it won't itch my skin, if that makes sense. I love it, though. It's kind of like this cropped. It's not too cropped, actually. It's kind of like a normal length cardigan, but not very long. Tortoiseshell buttons. It's almost like this mohair material of it. It's a V-neck. I picked it up in a size medium. Oh, here we go, actually. It's wool and alpaca blend. That might be why it's so itchy. Alpaca, do they actually mean like the animal? An alpaca animal? Do you reckon? It must be. Let's read it. Does it say anything about it? It's got these kind of like balloon sleeves on it as well, and then it really comes in tight on the cuffs. I've got a real vision for this jumper, so hopefully the outfit that I'm envisioning actually pulls off. But I feel like this was actually one of my favourite buys this week. Couple of other bits from H&M. This one here was influenced by the lovely Lissy Roddy from Instagram. Many of you must know her over there. She wore this, well maybe it wasn't this exact one, but this kind of style. She wore it with a white shirt underneath. I think a pair of long black boots. She looks very cool. She always looks very cool. But yeah, I just love these kind of knitted vests. I got it this once again in a size medium. It's definitely quite like a bigger fit, so I would say definitely stay true to size. And it was only $17.99, which I feel like was really good value for money. I think this would be really nice for work as well. If you wear like a shirt to work, to wear this over the top, it would be quite a nice thing to kind of mix up your outfit, but also keep you warm, like as we go into sort of winter months. I really like this. I'm not 100% what I'm going to wear it with yet, but I mean, you could always wear it as a dress. Maybe I'll wear it with like a long shirt and kind of long black boots maybe. I don't know, but I really liked it and I thought for the price, I'd pick it up. Sticking with the whole vest theme, and the last thing I got from H&M was this. Now, this is another vest. This was only $19.99 and once again, size medium. And this time it's a high neck one. It comes down a lot longer than the black one does. Just honestly, the quality of it and the way it feels is amazing for the price. It's also from their Conscious range, and it says here on the label what it's made out of. So it says 64% recycled polyester, 80% from pre-consumer waste, 20% from post-consumer waste. I mean, overall, I really like the fact that H&M do those ranges. And this I've already tried on. I think it looks really nice. Once again, the same kind of idea as I went for with the black one. So like a white shirt underneath it, pair of leather leggings, a nice pair of black boots. I just feel like it's really lovely and something like a little bit different. And also the fact it hasn't got any sleeves makes it a really good transitional piece because, like I've told you guys, it's not very cold right now. So before I get into my Zara box, I actually just want to quickly show you these boots that I picked up this week from Topshop and I'm absolutely in love with. Honestly, I don't really want to touch the bottom because I have worn them out once, but they are brilliant. So they're real leather. They were, I think, $69, maybe $89.99. I'm not too sure. I'll link everything down below like I always do. Honestly, love them so much. I think they look like such a good dupe of the Prada ones. You know, the short Prada ones that everyone's wearing with the bag around the side. Truth is, I don't actually like the bag around the side. So I like the fact that these don't have that. They are super comfortable. They've got this kind of platform on them as well, so make your legs look a little bit longer, which I love with boots, because sometimes with boots like this, it can make your legs appear really short because they kind of cut you off halfway up the calf. These don't at all. They make your legs look nice and long. They're super comfy, like I said. I haven't had to break them in at all. You all know how much I love my Dr. Martens, which I still do love. I've worn them. Have I worn them already this year? I must have done. I think I have. Yeah, I definitely have. But boy, if you are a Dr. Martin owner, you know how much it takes to break those things in. These, honestly, I've worn them only once so far. They've been so comfortable. And I just wanted to share them with you all because if you're in the market for a good winter boot, 1000% recommend these. And I just, yeah, I just really love them. The only thing I do actually have to say about them is they're a little bit of a nightmare to put on and take off because There's no zip, so it's all laces. So you have to kind of undo the laces a lot to get your foot in. But once your foot's in, you're all good. Size-wise though, they are a little bit big, but I just got my regular size and I decided to keep them because I thought I can wear thick socks and I much, much rather my shoes be a little bit big than too small. But if you are in between sizes and you're umming and ahhing, I probably would say size down. So yeah, I wanted to make sure I shared those with you all because I absolutely love them and I also feel like they are definitely going to sell out. So if you want them, be quick. Now, let's get into this Zara order. I haven't even opened this myself yet. So, let's get this thing open and, oh God, hang on. Ah! Okay, I didn't actually pick up, if I can remember rightly, that much from Zara. Because, well, I actually don't really feel like Zara killing it that much this season. Like, I do like some of the stuff they're doing, but I'm not kind of obsessed as I thought I'd be. So, two of the things I picked up are very, very similar. Once again, only gonna keep one of these, or maybe none of them if I don't like them. But let's start with this. Now, this is a faux leather blazer. On first impressions, it looks a completely different color to what it looked like on the website. In real life, it looks a very kind of like minky, almost purpley gray. No, brown. Is that gray or brown? Where online, it looks like a really nice beige. So Zara, I feel like you've totally lied to me with this one. I picked it up in a size medium because it said it was already an oversized fit. And it was $49.99. I don't know how this is going to fit. You're probably seeing me in a cutaway right now. But it just wasn't the colour I was expecting at all. So, yeah, I feel a little bit annoyed about that, Zara. The next piece was another blazer. Oh, my goodness. This feels unbelievable. This blazer, wow, it's literally the smushiest. Well, it's faux leather. It's not real leather. Oh my God, I've never felt faux leather. I was just smelling it, didn't smell like fish. I feel like faux leather always stinks of fish, but it doesn't. And oh my goodness, the leather quality, or the faux leather quality of this is unbelievable. So I picked this up in a size large. It was $69.99. And this definitely is true color to what is on the website. So this is a really gorgeous brown. Honestly, I know I've said it 20 times already, but this leather honestly feels unbelievable. I was thinking I could wear this with so many different things. I was thinking I could wear it with like a pair of cream trousers and then like a white top and a pair of beige heels, you know, like for an all nude kind of look. I was also thinking I could wear it with a pair of black jeans. I was also thinking I could wear it with like a roll neck that's this kind of color. But overall, I'm super impressed with how this feels. I also feel like it really complements my hair quite nicely. The next pieces I picked up, why on earth did I order one, two, three of the same bodysuits? I have absolutely no idea. But I don't know if any of you have seen a meme about these bodysuits recently. I actually can't remember what the meme said, but it was kind of just saying like every girl owns one of these Zara bodysuits, and I honestly own about 20 of them in white, black and nude. So I got these, I think it's because I picked up them one in a size medium and two in size small, because I'm kind of like, I need something in between, like I'm a small and a half. Does that even make sense? Like, I'm totally in between sizes with these, where a medium's too big and a small sometimes is too tight. If I've had a heavy week that week with the amount I've eaten, a small is like a sausage skin. But then if I've been kind of good, like a medium's gaping on me, so it's kind of hard to judge. But these are the handiest things ever, just to put underneath jumpers, to wear with jeans, to wear with blazers, to wear with absolutely anything, basically. Like I say, I have them in pretty much every colour. And they're really, really good value for money. Now, the last piece I picked up, and ooh, possibly one of my favourites. I actually saw these in a Zara store the other day, but I had already ordered them online, so I left them and knew that I was going to like them, or hopefully like them, when they turned up. So, my God, they look extremely long. God, doesn't that look so long for like a size 4 boot? Anyway, I just want to confirm these definitely are a size 37, which is a UK 4. Wow. But what this is, or what these are, if I got the other one out, are pointed sock boots. So you can all see. Why am I like explaining when you can all see exactly what they are? I have a pair of black pointed sock boots, as many of you know. I absolutely adore them. They go with everything. They make your legs look so slim because they kind of like elongate. You can't really see like where the sock joins your leg, or you know what I mean? And basically, I have some really lovely kind of nude leather trousers. I also have some nude suede trousers. And I always struggle to think of what shoe to wear with them. Then the other day, I was kind of putting an outfit together and it was a cream coat, a pair of nude leather leggings. And I thought, you know what I really need? I really need a nude sock boot. And I went on the Zara website and lo and behold, here they were. a nude sock boot. They're actually more of like a creamy nude, so they're not brown, they're more like white. They're not white, I mean, they're kind of showing white on camera, but what I mean is they're like a lighter beige than a darker beige. Does that make any sense? I just feel like there's so many outfits for me that these are gonna go with. And the heel height on them isn't too crazy either. So hopefully I could wear them in the daytime, maybe to lunch or something like that. But I just feel like I really needed these in my wardrobe. And hopefully they look as nice on as they do off. Although they don't actually look that great off because they look so big. They kind of look like the Balenciaga ones. You know, the Balenciaga knife boots, well, that have a really long pointed heel at the front. They kind of look like that. I haven't even told you the price of them, have I? They were 49, wow, that's actually really, really good value for money. So they were only $49.99. Well, they were my last items of my Mango, H&M, Zara, and Topshop order. I feel like I've done all my favourite high street brands there. Hope you've enjoyed this. I feel like I've been bringing you haul after haul at the moment. But I love hauls and I love shopping online. And hopefully it kind of gives you a little bit of helping hand to see what you'd like to order and me give you a little bit of idea sidewise and stuff as well. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Take care. Bye.